This song was one that I wasn't sure was gonna make the album. We had a gigantic folder saved on the cloud of tunes that Jacob had written, and this was one that really stuck out to me, but I didn't know what to do with it. At one point, Jacob and another friend of his had written some music, some melody and lyrics to it. He was like, hey, do you want to kind of hear what I had? And I was like, nope, don't want to hear that at all. And you know, not to insult him at all, I just, sometimes, unless I'm really stuck, I don't want to hear what's already been done with something because I want to have that kind of ownership in it. I don't even remember where it came from. I just remember the melody came in and then the lyrical content. Back in 2016, our grandmother was in a car accident that led to a week-long stint in the ICU, and it ultimately took her life. She was getting ready to go home and ended up having a stroke that completely debilitated her and killed any and all brain activity that she had. And it's devastating if you're close to your grandparents. And we grew up with all of our living grandparents. We were close to all of them. And so when we lost her, she was kind of the glue that held the family together. And the last goodbye, it was written from my memories of just sitting in the hospital with her. I remember sitting there holding her hand in the ICU and singing, you know, just singing stuff from musicals like Beauty and the Beast or Les Miserables, musicals that I had gone to see with her, just hoping against hope that something would snap her out of this, because the neurologist said it could happen. I still vividly remember the cold lights of that room and just how stale it was in there, just no life whatsoever. Within the walls of that room. And so the song was about that experience, compounded with the stuff that I wish I could have said. Eventually, it took her. And there's one kind of, I guess, hidden gem, I don't mind calling it a joke in the song, because our grandmother was very much a jokester. Even in the afterlife, she was a jokester. Maybe we'll tell the story of her pranking us at her graveside. And our grandfather pranked us at his graveside a few years later, but Jacob and I love the movie Airplane with Leslie Nielsen. One of the most famous quotes from that is, you know, Shirley, you can't be serious. I am serious, and don't call me Shirley. And then another one of our favorite quotes from it is, you know, Leslie Nielsen pops into the cockpit on this airplane, and he's like, just wanted to tell you both good luck, and we're all counting on you. And so the day our grandmother was supposed to be going home from the hospital before she had her stroke, we were delivering some papers. Our mom was working on a real estate deal, and so we were delivering papers to her and gave them the papers, and I walked out and I stepped back in. I said, just want to tell you all good luck, and we're all counting on you. And our grandmother, we called her honey, she said, and don't call me Shirley. And so in the second verse, it says, I thought surely this was not the way this was going to end. And that was very intentional. It's the Shirley joke. And I mean, like, obviously it's a big deal. Got my tattoo here. It says, don't call me Shirley with the twisted airplane on it. So the song was kind of our send off for her. Like many of the others, it was a really hard song to write and very hard song to record. But the time has come for us to say goodbye.